viewers, welcome back to my channel. So let's start today's topic. Today we are going to do circle level 1 problems. We have already discussed the basic definition and technical terms and formulas in our earlier class. So let's use that all the stuff over here. Let's do our first question. Find its circumference, its area. Okay, so here what's the formula for the circumference? 2 pi r, or we can say pi d, and area is pi r square. Okay, so it's a direct formula. You need to, whatever the values we have, that we need to substitute in this formula. So 2 and the pi value he has given us 22 over 7 times, and radius. So radius is 21 centimeters. So we have to take out the common factors, which is 7 threes are 21. Then whatever left, that all we need to multiply. Okay, so 2 2s are 44 3s are 132 centimeters. Okay, so here I didn't take pi d because the value he has given is radius, not diameter. So that's why I substituted in 2 pi r. Okay, next we will see the area for the same picture. So area is pi r square. So pi is nothing but 22 over 7, radius is 21 centimeters. So we have to multiply 2 times 22 over 7 times 21 times 21. So we need to take out the common factors, which is 7 threes are 21. Then whatever the leftover value we have, we need to multiply, which is 2 times of 3, which is 66. 66 times 21, which is 1386. If you want, you can calculate. Okay, then always area is centimeter square, because we are multiplying radius 2 times cm times cm, which is cm square. So 1386 cm square. Okay, let's see next question. So here we got diameter, so which is d, 14 centimeters. So we will use the formula pi d in place of 2 pi r. So pi d, which is 22 over 7 times 14 centimeters. So 7, 2 times, then 2 times 2, which is 44 centimeters, is a circumference. Now let's find out area. So area formula is pi r square, but we have diameter, so we need to get the radius from this. So how to get the radius? Just half of the value, which is 7 centimeters. Let me clear the board. So here its value is 132 centimeters circumference, and area is 1386 centimeters square. I didn't write units, you just write it down. And here for this circle, the circumference is 44 centimeters, and area is, we need to calculate. Okay, let's do it. 22 over 7 times 7. I already told, right, this is diameter, so radius is 7. So take out common factors, then multiply. 22 over 7 is the area of this circle, which is equal to 154. If you want, you can calculate. 7 2s are 14, 7 2s are 14 plus 1, which is 154 centimeter square. Yeah, so let's see next problem. These are all very simple problems, direct problems. Just you need to substitute the values in the formula. That's it. So let's see the next question. Yeah, calculate the curved part of the semicircle and quarter circles below. What do you mean by curved parts of the semicircle? We didn't hear about this, right? We heard about circumference, area and perimeter. So here they didn't ask those things. They ask curved part of the semicircle, means actually they want this, only this part. So in a circle, the circumference and the perimeter both are same. Okay, but whereas for the semicircle, the perimeter is different. So you need to add the curved part and as well as the horizontal line, so which is a diameter. For the circle, the two values are same, circumference and perimeter both are same, but not for the semicircle. And for the quarter circle, the circumference or perimeter is different. So you need to add the curved part and as well as this diameter line, so which is horizontal line, we need to add. But here he is asking only curved part of the semicircle. So how to get that value? It's very easy. The half of the circumference, we can take it as a curved part of the semicircle. If you wanted to say same in the form of formula, that is half times pi d, we can take it as a curved part of the semicircle. Okay, that's how we will get this value. So now we have all the values, we have formula, so we can substitute the values. Half times 22 over 7 times d, diameter is 42 centimeters. Let's take out the common factor, 76 are 42, then 11 2s are 22, so which is 66 centimeters. So the curved part of this semicircle is 66 centimeters. If they ask about perimeter of the semicircle, then we need to add this diameter value to this curved part of the semicircle, then we will get the perimeter of this semicircle. So what we need to do, we need to find out the curved part of the semicircle, and then we need to add this diameter to this value to get the perimeter of the semicircle. Next, how to find out the curved part of the quarter circle. So here also same concept. So we need to take out the 1/4 part of the circumference of the circle. So which is 1/4 of times pi times d. Okay, so to get that value, so here also we have all the values, just substitute the values into the formula. So which is 1/4 of pi means 22 over 7 times d. So d is how much? This is radius and centimeters. So what could be the diameter? So which is 14 centimeters. Now let's take out the common factors. 7 2 are 14, 2 table 2 times, 2 table 11 times. So the curved part of the quarter circle is 11 centimeters. So here also, if you want to get the perimeter, you need to add 11 centimeters plus one horizontal line and one vertical line. So for the semicircle we got 66 centimeters, and for the quarter circle we got 11 centimeters. That's how we need to calculate the curved part of the semicircle and quarter circle. So let's see the next question. For each semicircle, find its perimeter. We already discussed about how to find out the perimeter. So before we find perimeter, we need to find out the curved part of the semicircle. So how to find out the curved part of the semicircle? What is the formula? So which is half of pi d. So let's substitute those values in the formula. So here pi is equal to 22 over 7, and he has given radius 7 centimeters. If radius is 7 centimeters, then diameter is equal to 14 centimeters, 2 times of radius, right? So substitute that value in the formula. Now let's take out the common factor. 7 2s are 14 and 2 11s are 22 or 2 1s are 2. Okay, so the answer is 22 centimeters, and you need to add the diameter is 14 centimeters. Then the perimeter is equal to 36 centimeters. Okay, and let's see for this semicircle. So again, we need to find out the curved part of the semicircle, which is half 22 over 7 times d. Already he has given 28. Let's take out the common factors, then we need to multiply the values, which is equal to 44 centimeters. 44 centimeters is the curved part area. Then what is the diameter? Which is 28 centimeters. So if we add together, then it is 72 centimeters. That's the values of perimeters of both the semicircles. That's how we need to solve the perimeter of the circle. So these are all the basic level 1 problems where you need to substitute your values in a particular formula, and then we will get our values. So that's it for today's session. I hope you understand all the problems. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Bye bye.
Don't forget, age is just a number. Happy learning.